why today, 5 years later, is the ACA still probably, I won't say unpopular, but doesn't command majority support even today?
You know, I think we as an administration haven't done as much as we could to make sure people understand the breadth of the benefits, and that the ACA became about a very narrow thing, an important thing. It became even narrower than the uninsured. It became about the marketplace at one point in time. But it is about so much more. And so making sure that people understand that benefits that they get every day and that they're using are things that are a part of the Affordable Care Act. There are things that are now in the fabric. And I think most people agree. I mean, the pre-existing conditions is just one of many things. The 20 up to 26-year-olds, those are things that people now accept as part of our healthcare system.
And when you leave office in a year and a half, would you expect that most people would talk about it as the ACA or Affordable Health Care Act as you do, or will it still be known primarily as Obamacare?
You know what I hope most Americans talk about is I hope they talk about a system where they get better quality and it's more affordable. That they actually talk about what it is and what it means for them.
You don't care what they call it if that's the case?
I do not, because really that's what I believe this is about. And I think the more that we give people the information to make their choices, that's the empowered consumer. And that's both of their choices in politics and their choices in the substance of their health care. Because I believe the American people, when given that information, they make good choices.